It's linear algebra time, and we're continuing this exciting look into vectors. And what we're going to look at today specifically is a very simple idea of vector addition. We're just going to do vector addition, and we're going to look at it in two ways. One is this as far as this geometric interpretation is concerned. If I have two axes and I have two vectors, there is a vector and there is a vector, and I just want to add them. And you must have seen this before. Remember, this vector has an x-axis value, let's call this x sub 1, and here an x, let's make it y sub 1. And of course, if it was in higher dimensional space, in three dimensions and hyper dimensions, you just carry on with these. This one will have its own, let's make that x sub 2, and its own y sub 2. And you can well imagine when we do this, we just add those two together, these two components. So it'll be x1 and x plus x2, that'll be the resultant, and y1 plus y2. What we are really doing is the following. We're taking this vector, and we are moving it along so that it's tail is at the head of this first one. So it's going to be this parallel movement there, let's make it there. There we go. And of the similar length, and that's there. This value here will be x sub 1 plus x sub 2, and this value here, let's make this, that'll be y sub 1 plus y sub 2. That's very easy to see. And what you actually have is this parallelogram, and the resultant vector is going to be that. Very simple notation. Now, we had scalar multiplication when it comes to matrices. We also get scalar multiplication of a vector. If I take this vector and I multiply it by 2, the direction, its angle, is never going to change. It is just going to get longer, so multiply by 2, but I can multiply it by a half, and I can multiply it by negative 1. I can multiply that by negative 1. It's just going to be in this direction. And before we carry on with that, let's just think about just doing this in vector notation. I have my one vector, vector v, and that is going to have components x1 and y1, and that is a column vector. And I have vector 2, and that is going to be x sub 2, y sub 2, those values that we see there, as I said, in multiple dimensions. So if we go v1 plus v2, that is just going to be x sub 1 plus x sub 2 and y sub 1 plus y sub 2. It's a very simple idea. Very simple to do that. As I say, in higher dimensions, it just carries on. These two have to have the same dimensions. They have to live in the same space, though. If they don't live in the same space, two-dimensional space, one-dimensional space for scalar, two-dimensional space, three-dimensional space, hyperspace, they've got to live in the same space, and then you can simply, very simply, just add these vectors to each other. And that just really brings me to the, or why I mentioned the scalar multiplication, is I reverse the first one here, but let's reverse the second one here by multiplying throughout by negative 1. If I do that, all I'm going to do is I'm reversing the direction of this. So if I want v sub 1 minus v sub 2, if I want that to happen, very easy. It is just the addition of minus 1, the scalar multiplication of v2. So I just reverse it and then I add it. So don't get confused when you see these things being drawn this way and then some convoluted thingy happening with that. Remember that we have this binary operation between two elements of some given set. This is the set of vectors in that specific space. And the addition is just subtraction is just addition with this scalar multiplication of negative 1. With the second element there after our binary operation. So very easy to do, to think about vector addition, just as far as looking at it like this and having this very simple concept in your head as to what is happening there. Once you represent, of course, vectors in this form, in this column vector form, it's a very simple thing to do, vector addition, and then together with that vector subtraction. Let's go to Mathematica and see how we can accomplish this. So let's have a quick look at vector addition. Let me just do two vectors. My one vector is going to hold as a column vector 1, 2, and plus my second one, let's make that very obvious that we're going to do, let's make it 10 and 20 as my second one. And all you can see is that it's element-wise addition. So 1 and 10 is 11, 2 and 20 is 22. Remember, if I wanted to see, or one way to see it as a column vector, is just to do this, matrix form. Don't think I showed that yesterday, but just 1, 2, it looks like it is a row, but it's not. You can clearly see that it's not a nested list. And in matrix form, a single row like this is going to be seen as a column vector. So remember when we had this, just our little arrow there, and I just wanted to show you how easy it would be just to turn around this one so we can do that negation. So that will just be -1 times, so that'll be -3. And if I look at that, my first one is still here from 0, 0 to 1, 1, 0, 0 to 1, 1, but instead of 0 to 3, we have 0 to -3. And that's how you're going to do the subtraction. Because if I were to say, let's say 1, 2, and I were to subtract, for instance, let's make that then the 10, 20, you're going to see that we have 1 minus 10, which is -9, and 2 minus 20, which is -18. So really, vector addition and vector subtraction, irrespective of the dimensions that you are in, as long as it's the same dimensions, it's a very, very easy thing to do, a vector addition inside of Mathematica.